Some ups and downs.
Trials.
Some trials and some tribulations. And you know, Val read that scripture talking about the love of God. You know what had happened? Israel had suffered for 430 years. They had been mourning. And then groaning. And all of a sudden, if we moan and groan long enough, he will surely come to see about it.
Right.
Yeah, I hear that Sister James's daughter speaking for the whole family. How they was thanking and praising the Lord for giving them an opportunity to see their mother go down in that liquor grave. Like Jesus was carried down there in the River Jordan. And then brought up.
Straightway.
Yes.
And got a witness from heaven. Well, that's the same Israelites. And then got caught up with Pharaoh. You see, the our pastor told Sister James that she was going to have trials and tribulations. And then the very ones that you think is your friend. They will turn their back on you. On this journey.
Make it plain, Ella.
But if you got your hand in the hand of the Lord, everything will be all right. Because as Israel, the one that God loved with an everlasting love, as they was traveling, you see, God's word, is so plain. That a fool. And a wayfarer. They can understand. Because he was showing. Sometimes, we looking, way out there. And it's right in our own family. It's not only the brothers and sisters of the church.
All right now.
Your own blood brother. There was one preacher. Joseph had then got caught up. In that lecture. And he was the water boy. Even to his own brother. They would work out in the field. And there was sound then. His father. Preacher. Take a little water. To your brother. And see how they get along. But when they look up, Sister Jane, and see you coming. They have a name for you too.
You're preaching out of the outside.
So that come, that old dream. They got together. Along got the devil. And his people. What we ought to do to him. Let's kill him. One still said, no, we ain't gonna kill it. But we gonna sell it. A few pieces of silver.
That's what it is.
They'll sell you out too.
Bring that up.
Because what they don't understand is all the gold and the silver and the cattle of a thousand hills. They were all the gold. So here comes the Egyptian. The devil's crap. That crowd that builds them a guard. Out in the field. They nailed wood together. He looked like he got on. they look like they got legs and feet. And they have to make him some eyes. And you can call all day.
He can't call.
I don't see about you. Because he can't walk. On his show, can't talk. He don't have
preach that, Hart! Preach that!
We gon' sell him, to the Egyptians. Then when we get back home, we gon' tell our father, about a raven beast, destroyed him. So they poured blood. That same blood. They took that coat that the father had made. Of many colors. Poured blood on it. And carried it back. To the old man. A raven beast. Your son Joseph. And those Egyptians. They carried him. On down. That Egypt land. Before that Pharaoh, a king. What that mean, my love, is, as soon as you get over, one little hill, there's a mountain, standing before you. Our mothers, and our fathers, they had a hard time, on this journey. They had to make a fire, they set the pot, on the stove. But nowadays, we just turn the button. We push a button. The lights come on. Mount Zion. My love, they carried him down there. What an old Pharaoh was. You see, my love, when God is going to lay his hands on you, you got a different look. Our pastor told me. And then you got a different walk. You got a different talk. Lord Joseph, I must have been good looking. Because when he got out of there, that old king, Pharaoh king, his wife, laid his eyes on him. And told her, let's make him the butler. Even on the house. They went along with it. But she had other things.